Welcome to Fact 5 Minutes, your one-stop shop for interesting and informative facts. We cover a wide range of topics, from human behavior and social issues to science, astronomy, culture, and art. So whether you're a curious learner or just looking for a quick break from the everyday, Fact 5 Minutes has something for you. We publish new videos every week, so be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss out. And if you find our videos helpful, please leave us a like, comment, and share them with your friends. The deformed bug. Assassin bugs are known for their extremely peculiar saliva, which has the ability to liquefy their prey. However, they also have a very strange hobby. That is, they use the remaining shells of their prey as decorations and armor. When an assassin bug kills its prey, it will first suck out the internal fluids of the victim, leaving only the shell. The bug will then use its rostrum, a sharp, curved structure that it uses to pierce its prey, to attach the shell to its back. The exact mechanism by which the bug is able to attach the shell to its back is unknown. However, it is thought that the bug may use a sticky substance to hold the shell in place. The use of the shell as a decoration and armor is thought to provide several benefits for the bug. First, it helps to camouflage the bug, making it more difficult for predators to spot. Second, it provides the bug with some protection from predators. Third, it may help to attract mates. The selfish tree. The baobab tree, scientifically known as Adansonia, is one of the largest and most selfish trees in the world. Indeed, living in arid environments in Africa, Australia, and India, the baobab takes advantage of its massive physical advantage to store up to 120,000 liters of water in its trunk for its own use. Talking about physical advantage, the baobab belongs to the group of the largest trees in the world with a trunk circumference of up to 47 meters, a trunk diameter of up to 11 meters, and a height of up to 30 meters. It is also believed that this is a long-lived species, although how long it can live is still controversial, with only one individual named the big baobab in South Africa believed to be over 1,060 years old. The baobab's ability to store water is a remarkable adaptation that allows it to survive in dry environments. The tree's thick, spongy trunk is able to absorb and store water during the rainy season, which it then uses to survive during the dry season. Speaking of trees, the title of the tallest tree in the world belongs to a redwood named Hyperion in California, USA, with a height of 115.92 meters, while the largest tree in the world in terms of volume belongs to General Sherman, which is still a redwood with 1,487 cubic meters of wood. Interesting plants. In the tropical rainforests of some Central and South American countries such as Costa Rica, Ecuador, Panama, and Colombia, there is a species of tree that has flowers that at first glance look no different from the lips of a seductive girl. And it is not known if that is why they are commonly known as hooker's lips. Talking about interesting plant species, the monkey orchid has a face that is quite similar to monkeys. The Aristolochia salvadorensis species has a similar appearance to Darth Vader in the Star Wars series. The Anguilloa uniflora species has flowers that look exactly like babies in cradles. The Impatiens bacardii species looks like a little girl dancing. More interesting, many plants have organs that describe human body parts, such as the fungus that resembles ears, the guarana fruit that resembles eyes, or the dried flower of the snapdragon plant that resembles a human skull. In particular, there is the Pong Kador Moha Tep tree found in some remote areas of Cambodia and the Peter pepper that has the exact shape of the male genitalia. And to make it a pair, some parts of some plant species also accidentally have a shape that is quite similar to the female genitalia. Cold-blooded creatures. If humans and most other animals are naive and dependent on their parents in the early years of life, there are also creatures that are born as cold-blooded killers. Indeed, unlike most other creatures, the environment inside the womb of tiger sharks is incredibly cruel and bloody. During the breeding season, a tiger shark female can mate with many males in one night, so the eggs in her stomach will be fertilized at different times by sperm from different husbands, forming a rather crowded team of half-brothers on both sides of the uterus. When the first fertilized eggs develop into tiger sharks about 10 centimeters long, the great massacre begins. The older siblings will search for and eat any younger siblings they find until they become the only individual in their uterus. Not only that, after they have eaten their younger siblings, they continue to find their mother's two ovaries and eat them clean. As a result, instead of giving birth to about 10 to 15 small, weak cubs that could become dinner for any creature, now from the birth hole of the female tiger shark, two tiger sharks are born from two separate uterine chambers, each with a length of 95 to 125 centimeters, healthy and aggressive. This horrific practice, in addition to increasing the survival rate of the young, has also been used to explain the superior sperm production in tiger sharks compared to many other relatives, along with the habit of guarding their mate after each mating as a way to ensure that their offspring will have the highest chance of survival. Event boundary. Have you ever walked into a room and forgotten why you went in there? This silly phenomenon is known as event boundary. According to a study from the University of Notre Dame in Indiana, the United States, the act of walking through a doorway creates an event boundary, or more simply, an event boundary in the mind, which separates the subject's activity phases into separate blocks of memory. More specifically, in this experiment, the researchers believe that the human brain divides the events of the day into separate compartments associated with the space or environment where the event took place. In other words, walking from one room to another will inadvertently cause the brain to think that the event in the previous room has ended, and at the same time package all the information related to that event into a separate storage compartment, including the reason for your step into the second room. Chicken and egg. If you are interested in the classic question of whether the chicken or the egg came first, then you might also be interested in the question of whether the orange was named after the color orange or the color orange was named after the orange fruit that is orange in color. However, unlike the scientific and mind-bending question of the chicken and its egg, the answer to the question of the orange and the color orange is quite clear and easy to understand. The word orange was used to name the fruit known scientifically as Citrus sinensis long before it was used to name the color orange for the first time in 1512. Before this time, the color orange was referred to as yellow-red, or red-yellow. Incidentally, if anyone is still stubborn every time they are asked whether the chicken or the egg came first, then I would like to give a brief answer that the chicken egg came first. And if you are preparing to argue that if there is no chicken, then where did the egg come from? Or if there is no egg, then what the hell hatched the chicken? Then remember that this is precisely why you don't really know whether the chicken or the chicken egg came first. It is important to remember that chickens, like humans, dogs, and cats, did not just appear on Earth out of nowhere. We all evolved from our ancient ancestors. It is assumed that over time, birds that looked like chickens but were not chickens laid eggs with slight mutations in their chromosomes, resulting in a new creature. Through a process of evolution and adaptation, combined with human breeding and speciation, this new creature gradually became a chicken, and by this logic, the chicken egg must have come first. Sniffing. Social. Why do dogs like to sniff the butts of their own kind and even the butts of other species? The shortest answer is that it is a form of social courtesy. Indeed, unlike humans who have the ability of flexible language and the ability to greet, hug, or shake hands when meeting, dogs are gifted with a special superpower, the super ability to smell. If you don't know or have forgotten, the sense of smell of dogs is about 10,000 to 100,000 times stronger than that of humans, with 125 million to 300 million scent receptors, compared to only 5 million in humans. The brain part that processes smell in dogs is also 40 times larger than the human counterpart, of course based on the ratio. Back to the main issue of sniffing butts. A dog sniffing the butt of another dog, even if they are not familiar with each other, is similar to you shaking hands to greet someone new. So, when a dog sniffs the butt of another dog, it is not just being rude or disgusting. It is actually gathering important information about the other dog, such as its gender, age, diet, health condition, and even its mood. This information is important for dogs to communicate with each other and to build relationships. For example, a dog can use the information it gathers from sniffing another dog's butt to determine whether the other dog is a potential threat or a potential friend. In addition, sniffing butts can also be a way for dogs to show affection and trust. When a dog sniffs the butt of another dog, it is essentially saying, "I am interested in you and I want to get to know you better." The act of sniffing butts is not as gross as it may seem to humans. Dogs have a special organ in their noses called the Jacobson's organ, which helps them to filter out the smell of feces when they are sniffing other animals. So, next time you see a dog sniffing the butt of another dog, don't be grossed out. Just remember that it is all part of the way dogs communicate and build relationships. You have just watched the video, Interesting Facts, by Fact 5 Minutes. Thank you for your attention. Please let us know your experience by leaving comments below the video. For now, goodbye and see you in the next videos.